Hello students, last time we have explained about the life cycle of the jowar stem borer. Now we will explain the second crop pest, the red cotton bug. So this is the second type of crop pest which we are going to explain with respect to its identification marks, life cycle, nature of damage and the control measures. So the red cotton bug also belongs to the phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Hemiptera, family Pyrochoridae, genus Digidercus and species Cingulatus. The red cotton bug has a wide distribution. It is the minor pest of the cotton growing region of the North India, particularly Punjab and Uttar Pradesh. This pest also occurs throughout the Maharashtra, but it is of minor importance. It is commonly known as cotton stainer. The host plants of the red cotton bug are cotton, bhendi, ambadi, hollyhock and several other malvaceous plants. Then regarding the identification marks of the red cotton bug, the adult bug measures about 12 to 15 millimeter in length. The females are being longer, about 15 millimeter, and males are shorter with a length of 12 millimeter. It is blood red in color except eyes, scutellum, anal, antennae, which are black colored. Besides, there is a black spot on each of the membranous forewing and a series of white transverse bands are present on the ventral side of the abdomen. Mouth parts are adopted for piercing and sucking of the cell sap, and the mouth parts of the red cotton bug having a straight beak or a rostrum which is useful for sucking of the plant juices. The nymphs or young stages or the life stages are smaller than adult and are wingless. Then the life cycle of red cotton bug. So this is the diagram or the diagrammatic representation. The first small figure representing the adult bugs with about 12 to 15 millimeter length, then body having three distinct divisions of the body, that is head, thorax, abdomen, then two pairs of wings and three pairs of legs together with a pair of antennae and a straight beak which is present in front of the head as a piercing and sucking type of mouth part. Then two pairs of wings. In case of red cotton bug, the first pair of wing, which is membranous, thin and having red color with two black spots, and the entire body of the red cotton bug is blood red in color except the head region, scutellum, then antennae or legs, these are black in color. And the adult bug has the transverse white bands on the ventral side of the abdomen. So the figure shows the adult moths. Then second figure in a showing mating in a red cotton bug, Digidercus, that is males and females join or get connected along their posterior ends and facilitating the process of mating or copulation so as to fertilize the eggs. Then another figure showing the eggs, then number of nymphal instars which are also having red color and getting, there are six moultings and there are about seven nymphal instars involved during the nymphal development or the larval development. And in the corner, we again can see the figure of the adult bug representing the head, thorax, abdomen, or the one pair of antennae with a head and the rostrum or the beak, and the thorax with two pair of wings and three pairs of legs and abdomen. So these are the three distinct regions of the body of adult bug. Then we will explain the life cycle of the red cotton bug in a detail. The mature females, the mature or adult females, on or after mating or copulation, lays eggs during the spring in a cluster of 70 to 80 number of eggs under the moist surface or fallen leaves and the cracks or crevices in the soil. The eggs are spherical. The eggs are spherical or the round in a shape, yellowish white in color, yellowish white in color, with about 1.2 millimeter length, with about 1.2 millimeter length. After 7 days of the infection, after 7 days of the incubation period, the most or the moist weather, eggs are hatching into active 1 millimeter long red color nymphs, which are resembling with the adult except an absence of wings. So the adult female, after fertilization, laying 70 to 80 number of eggs under the moist soil or under the moist surface fallen leaves and cracks and crevices in the soil. The eggs are spherical, yellowish white in color, measures up to 1.2 millimeter in length, and after laying these 70 to 80 number of eggs, fertilized eggs, which begins their embryonic development during the favorable conditions of the environment, that is moist weather, that is optimum temperature and the humidity, that is moist weather, which are the optimum parameters essential for the normal development of the eggs. So during the incubation period or the embryonic development of 7 days, eggs undergoes its embryonic development in a moist weather or with the optimum temperature and the humidity, undergoes embryonic development and getting transformed into the young stage or a larval form called as a first nymph or the first nymphal instar, with a length of 1 millimeter and a dark red color of the nymph, which are similar to the adult stage in its morphology. The first nymph, even though it is very small, up to 1 millimeter in length or red in color, having three distinct body divisions, that is head, thorax and abdomen, only they are smaller in size or miniature in size, and they are immature and lacking the wings. So they are immature and without wings. So the eggs on hatching, the nymph with a length of 1 millimeter, dark red color, and representing or resembling its form with a adult stage, except that they are smaller in size, absence of wings, or they are immature. The nymph feed gregariously on the cotton balls. The nymphs undergo 5 molts within a 49 to 89 days to reach the adult stage. So the red cotton bug, since it is the hemimetabolan insect showing incomplete metamorphosis and or a gradual metamorphosis, and the life cycle shows the stages of the nymph, which gradually develops and getting transformed into the advanced forms of the nymphal instars. So there are five moultings taking place during the nymphal development within a period of 49 to 89 days and passing through six instars or the nymphal instars and finally reach to the adult stage. So the nymphs undergo five moultings within a period of 49 to 89 days and then get transformed into the adult stage. In winter, the life of the adult bug is about 3 months, but in summer it is varied or different. The pest breed on cotton from August to November. The breeding or the reproductive activities of the red cotton bug taking place during the August to November and takes place shelter under the leaves or debris from December to the middle of March and feeds on the bhendi from April to July. So when there is a lack of cotton crop during the summer months, the pest is transferred onto the bhendi during the April to July. So during the months of April to July, the red cotton bug feeding onto the crop, that is bhendi. And during the monsoon month or monsoon season or rainy season, it infest or attack onto the cotton balls and feeding onto the cotton. So during cotton, that is during August to November. So during August to November, it undergoes its development or feeding onto the cotton. But during summer months, it attack or infest the bhendi crop. So these are the alternative host plants of the red cotton bug during the August to November, feeding onto the cotton, and during April to July, feeding onto the bhendi. The life cycle of the bug is completed within 6 to 8 weeks. So this is the total period required for the complete development or the transformation of the different life stages from egg to adult. That is, 6 to 8 weeks are required for the completion of the life cycle of the red cotton bug. So the eggs undergoes embryonic development within a period of 7 days, and then it is transformed into the nymphal instar, that is first nymph, that is having 1 millimeter length and dark red color, which is resembling with the adult stage, that is having head, thorax and abdomen, but immature stage and lacking the wings also. Then nature of damage. Both nymphs and adults suck the cell sap from the leaves and the tender shoots and impair the vitality of the plant. If the attack is severe, the balls, that is cotton balls, open badly and the cotton lint is of poor quality. In addition, they also feed on the seeds and lower their oil content and low percentage of germination. Such as seeds become unfit for sowing. The lint or the cotton lint is stained by the excreta of bugs or by their body juice as they are crushed in the ginning factories while removing the seeds. So this is about the nature of damage, means all the stages, that is larvae and the adult. The larvae of the red cotton bug are called as nymph. There are six nymphal instars, which are the life stages or the immature stages of the development or the life cycle of the red cotton bug, and which are having the similar morphology resembling with the adult, having the similar type of mouth parts. So the feeding habit of the nymph and the adult are same, and thus both nymph and adults, which are sucking the cell sap or the plant juices from the leaves, tender shoots, and impair the vitality of the plant or reducing the photosynthetic activity of the leaves of the cotton plant. And if the attack of the red cotton bug is severe, the cotton balls open abnormally or badly, and the quality of the cotton lint is poor. So poor quality cotton lint is thus obtained from the malformed cotton balls due to the infestation or the attack or the feeding of the red cotton bugs on the cotton plants, that is either leaves or onto the cotton fruits also. In addition, they also feed on the seeds, cotton seeds, and lower their oil content, and this leads to low percentage of the germination of the seeds due to the reduction in oil contents of the cotton seeds. Such seeds become unfit for sowing, and the cotton lint can be stained by the excreta of the bugs or by their body juices when crushed in a ginning factories. So this is, and that's why it is also called as a cotton stainer. The red cotton bug is also called as cotton stainer because the lint of the cotton is stained or colored due to the excreta of bugs or urine or their body juices when get crushed in the ginning factories. Then control measures. Control measures. So cotton field should be plowed deep to expose eggs to the sunlight. So first control measure or the cultural practice that can be practiced so as to control the red cotton bug or the stages of red cotton bug. So cotton field after harvesting should be plowed deep to expose eggs to the sunlight. So on exposure of the eggs to the sunlight, get a dried or dyed in a sunlight. Insects should be handpicked or collected and killed in a kerosene water. So whatever the adult insects occurring or present in the cotton field, that could be picked up manually and can be dipped in the kerosene or insecticidal water so as to kill them. The crops of bhindi should be sown as a trap crop, and pests collected there should be destroyed. So one can along with the cultivation of the cotton crop, we can plant the bhindi or a trap crop as a bhindi in the cotton field so as to attract the red cotton bug on the bhindi, from where we can collect them and can kill them or destroy them either in a insecticidal water. So there are several ways for killing these insects, either burning or burying or dipping them in a insecticidal water. Then another way to control the red cotton bug, that is moistened seed or a boiled cotton seeds. Moisten or boiled cotton seeds can be hung up at the different places in the cotton field where bugs can congregate or come together, and they may get killed in the kerosene mixed water. So we can hung up the boiled cotton seeds in several places in the cotton field where these adult bugs or nymphs can get together, from where we can collect them or we can trap them and can kill them by using kerosene or insecticidal water. Then a chemical control measure such as spraying of malathion 0.05% is found to be effective to control this pest. So spraying of the malathion on a cotton field whenever there is a infestation or the attack of the red cotton bug noticed in the cotton field, we can spray the insecticide, namely Malathion, with a 0.05% for the control of the red cotton bug. Then spraying of 1 liter endosulfan, 35% effective concentration, 0.25 liter phosphimidon, 100% effective concentration, and 1 liter phenytrothione, 100% effective concentration per hectare is also very effective for reducing the pest population. So these are the fifth and sixth control measures. These are the chemical control measures where we can use the spray of Malathion 0.05% on the cotton crop when there is infestation of the red cotton bug or attack of the red cotton bug in the cotton field. And the another type of chemical control, that is spraying of 1 liter endosulfan, 35 effective concentration, 0.25 liter, that is 250 ml of phosphimidon, 100% or effective concentration, and 1 liter of phenytrothione, 100% effective concentration per hectare is very effective to reduce the pest population. So these are the three different type of pesticides or insecticides can be used with a variable quantity or the concentration, and can be spread in the cotton field so as to reduce the pest population or the control of the red cotton bug. So this is about the red cotton bug. Next time we will explain the third crop pest, that is a brinjal fruit borer. So today we'll stop here. Thank you.